ladies and gentlemen, it's an honor to be here already for the second time in this venue. I'm glad to have the opportunity to speak about the research cooperation between Thailand and Germany. I'll try to have a brief gap after every slide so that you don't have to wait very long for the translation. My name is Georg Vermeyen and I'm director of the DAAD office in Thailand, that is the German Academic Exchange Service. And briefly introduce my organization. I guess nobody knows exactly what the DAAD is here. I'll talk about the research landscape in Germany, especially about the logistics management, then about trends in funding and cooperation, because this landscape is moving. And then I'll briefly introduce a few funding opportunities. Have a brief, or just at the end. Okay. Yeah, so the German Academic Exchange Service is an association. It is not a government institution, but it's an institution of the German universities. So you can see, you don't have to see any specific city just to see that we have universities everywhere, and they are spread pretty evenly, and those universities are members of the German Academic Exchange Service, so we are run by German professors. Well, fair enough, I would say most of our money comes from government funding, from the Federal Foreign Office, from the Ministry of Education and Research, from the European Union, from the Ministry of Development and Cooperation. Well, we're glad that we can say, well, we have sent about 2 million people abroad for studies, so it's not perfectly balanced, but it's not too bad. So a bit more than 1 million Germans went abroad, and slightly less than 1 million foreigners came to Germany to study. And well, how do we do that? We have a broad network. I mean, not as dense as the Sheka network. So we only have 55 proper offices and 500 and something representatives worldwide. And in the region here, you can see the pointer. So we have our center in Bangkok, we have one in Ho Chi Minh City, Kuala Lumpur, Singapore, and then we have bigger offices in Hanoi and Jakarta, covering the neighboring countries, so we try to be as close to the people as possible. Before I jump to the research in Germany itself, let me say that we have about 200 university cooperations between Germany and Thailand alone. And we support every year about 250 Germans coming to Thailand and 250 Thai going to Germany on scholarships. So plus, I don't know, I think right now we have about 10 German professors teaching at different Thai universities on fellowships. So we have quite close cooperations, I would say, especially in the field of research cooperation and university cooperation, not so much with student exchange. So that is always is a bit difficult in Thailand, I would say. In Germany, just to give you a broad idea about the research landscape, we have about 1,000 research institutions, a huge network of research centers and clusters, and more than 500,000 people work in research and development in Germany. I know this is way too many numbers for one slide. Yeah, nobody can remember them anyway. But the basic take-home message is that every German citizen, if you break it down per person, spends about 1,000 euros. That is, let's say, 40,000 Thai baht per person per year, from baby to the old man in the retirement. Everyone spends about 40,000 Thai baht per year on research and development. Now, where does this research take place? We have the big research institutions that you might know. Of course, we have universities, we have the Fraunhofer Institutes, we have one of them even here in Bangkok. We have the Helmholtz Research Centers, Leibniz, Max Planck. And of course, two-thirds of research and development actually takes place in the industry. Yeah, so if we talk about or think about research, people think of Max Planck Institutes or something, but most of the research is actually done in the industry. And you can see it's big car industry, chemical industry, software, and usually at this point I ask people, what do you need to be successful in German research? As a company? Well, most obviously you need a round logo. Now, without a circular logo, you will not make it among the top 8 in German industrial research. So, how does the logistics research in Germany work? Well, I've done a bit of research and realized that there are more than 60 different institutes doing research on logistics in Germany, mainly at universities and most of them in cooperation with the industry. Yeah, so you have very close research, university, industry, corporations. And just to give you the most outstanding example, in the city of Hamburg, we have 3 different universities. That's the University of Hamburg, then it's the Helmut Schmidt University of the Armed Forces, and it's the Kühne Logistics University. And those 3 universities together have 10 institutes doing research on logistics in that just one city of Hamburg.